So if you just want to tell us who you are, who you represent, and what normal means to you.
My name is Paul George. I work with CMYLC, California Foundation for Economics. And normal for me is an aspiration. It's something I hope that we all can come to some sort of common agreement to, and that is normal, meaning normal for me may be different to you, but normal means whatever I might need or require to be independent and self-sufficient and confident and prosperous. As an American, we live in a very wealthy community, society. There's no reason why we have to watch our brothers and sisters struggle. I look around here and I see people struggling, and I see them fighting for things that are so basic, and it's appalling. And anyway, normal would be, agreed that, I agree as others do, normal means different things to different people. I would like to see normal being me, as and you. Normal is your name, whatever happens to be the things that make you you. It's normal. I don't like normal as being part of a class or anything like that. I think that's just very unfair. Anyway, I guess that's it.
Great. Thanks a lot. Thanks for your time.
You're very welcome. Good luck with your project.
Can you tell me who you are and who you represent?
Well, in this case, I'll represent myself.
Okay, cool.
And I have a daughter, Elizabeth, who's now 27, who is totally blind.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember when we were trying to get her in the public mainstreaming system in the public school, we had this meeting. And they said, okay, she can be in the public school, but she cannot take up any more time than a normal student. So I said, okay, so what is that?
Mm-hmm.
And they said, well, you know, a normal student. Well, how much time is that? And they got very, very angry with us and thought that we were being disruptive and obstructive. But in fact, it was the $64,000 question, and Elizabeth ended up being in trouble. And now she's getting a PhD in
trouble. Awesome. I guess you've redefined what normal really means.
I don't know what normal means, and it's one of those words I try not to.
Cool. Excellent. Thanks so much. Hi.
Hi.
Can you tell us who you are and who you're representing today, or what organization you're representing?
My name is Kathleen Derby, and I'm representing NAMI, California.
Mm-hmm.
And the question, you asked a question about what normal is.
The question is, what's your idea of what does normal mean to you?
Well, I really can't answer that question, to tell you the truth. I can't think of what normal to me has a negative connotation, to tell you the truth. Normal, it sounds a little boring, and it sounds like something most people that I know probably wouldn't want to be. I think people like to be individuals and like to contribute something creative to this world, and to just be normal, it sounds like a little bit below average. So I guess that's about what normal means to me.
Thanks. That's a great answer.
Hi.
And can you tell us your name?
My name is Dawn Korea.
And are you representing any organization or group today?
NAMI Sacramento.
Cool. And our question is, what is normal to you, or what does that word normal mean to you?
Normal to me is something I wouldn't want to be.
And why not?
Because it is. It's just an average connotation.
Yeah, okay. Great. So is that all that you... how do you feel about people with disabilities in regards to the word normal?
There's probably no normal for a disability.
Do you think this is really normal for anyone?
No.
Yeah, great. Thanks a lot for your time. So, hi. Can you tell us your name?
Asia.
And are you here with a group today?
Yes.
What group are you here with?
IHSS.
IHSS, cool.
Mm-hmm.
I want to ask you a question about the word normal. What does that word mean to you?
Normal people doing normal activities.
And what about people with disabilities? Do they fit into that world?
Yes.
Do you know anybody with a disability?
Yes, my cousin.
And do you feel your cousin is as normal as anybody else?
Yes, she has two kids.
Mm-hmm.
I figure that is normal. I have two kids, and
right.
I have no disability, so that's all.
And did you come out here to support your cousin today, or?
Yes, at my union.
Great. Thanks so much for taking part today. Hi, can you tell us your name?
Hi, I'm Daniel.
Hi, Daniel. Daniel, what do you think of when you hear the word normal? What does that mean to you?
I don't think there's anything, there's no such thing as normal. I think we're just all human. We all just coexist and we all go through the same thing. We all breathe, we all eat, we all sleep, and there's no such thing as a typical normal. We share things in common as human beings.
Thanks so much for answering our question today. Take care. Bye-bye. Can you tell us who you are and who you're with today?
My name is Alan Reynolds, and I'm here as part of a coalition for California Coalition of Mental Health.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, those disabilities related to mental health.
So let me ask you, what do you think of the word normal? What does that mean to you?
Normal to me means what you might expect to encounter in your everyday experience. So the fact that you might walk down the street and you might see a whole lot of different types of people, labeling one of those groups as normal people and other groups as abnormal or not normal people, doesn't make sense. Diverse groups of people, and we have very diverse individuals in our city and in our country.
Yeah. Well, thanks for your time. That's a great answer.
All right.
Hi. Can you tell us who you are and who you're representing today?
My name is Mary Lou Breslin. I'm with Disability Rights Education Defense Fund.
Mm-hmm. And our question for you today is, what does normal mean to you, the word normal?
Oh, there's no such thing.
What about people with disabilities? Do they fit into that? When people hear people saying people with disabilities are normal, they're not normal, does that mean anything to you?
There's no such thing as normal. Everybody has characteristics and attributes that are their unique selves, and whatever you look like, whatever your height and color and weight and gender and disability or not disability or age or geographic location, it's all about who you are as a human. There's no such thing as normal. It was a made-up statistical analysis based on trying to figure out where the stars are. So I'm thrilled you guys are doing your campaign, and I hope you tell it like it is, because there's no such thing as normal.
Great. Thanks so much for your time.